Hey everyone. Today we're going to learn an easier way to listen for state changes if you're working with like a tab interaction and you want to make sure that all of them have been visited before you show like the final layer. There is an easier way to do that that does not require any type of conditions. So we'll talk about that today. All right, welcome back. My name is Jeff Batt, and if you haven't checked out my website already, go ahead and check out my website at learningdojo.ninja. Here you can check out all previous blog posts covering anything learning development related, so how to get the most out of your microphone, how to use Camtasia and storyline tips and tricks, and different graphics, and how to use stuff in PowerPoint, create animated GIFs. All of that is for free. You can go ahead and check that out at my blog. You can also download free templates in Articulate Storyline 360, as well as XAPI and video templates, and then full courses, everything from A to Z. If you're new to any of these tools or want to get caught up on any of these tools, you can go into Articulate Storyline 360, Adobe Captivate, XAPI Fundamentals, Camtasia, Articulate Rise, Custom Squirm, and HTML5 Video. Now, the reason why I wanted to create this video is because recently I reviewed another developer's storyline file, and they were trying to show a layer or have something happen as soon as all tabs had been visited. They had this trigger that would basically, on the timeline start, see if rectangle 1 was visited, rectangle 2 was visited, and rectangle 3 was visited, which works if you're coming back to the page and the timeline is restarting. It would check to see if all those have been visited, and if they've been visited, then it would trigger that at that point. There is an easier way without having to use any type of condition. So if I actually double click on this, let's go ahead and change this over to not use any type of conditions, but we're going to change the event. Now, the event is when the trigger actually fires. The trigger is the action. And so in this case, the action needs to be set the character to normal. We're going to show that character. But the event is where we can take advantage of different objects being a certain type of state. So I'm going to go ahead and delete these different conditions here because we know that that won't work. So I'm going to go ahead and delete all three of them. And then we're going to change the event here to be state. Now, the nice thing about this is based on the state, as long as you don't have a selected state, which kind of stays there, this should work. So keep that in mind. But I'm going to select this drop-down box and I'm going to select all these different objects. Of the objects, it's going to show that it says that I can do it based on the visited state. As long as I have a visited state as well, make sure that all of your objects have a visited state. Otherwise, this won't work. I'm going to go ahead and do that, and I don't have to add any other types of conditions. I can go ahead and just click OK here. And now let's go ahead and preview this just to make sure it's working. So just a simple example that I have, I want to show this character as soon as I've clicked on all three different tabs here. Here we go. We have tab 1, tab 2, tab 3. Oh, so I forgot to change the state if all rectangles is visited. Let me just make sure that those are rectangle. Okay, there we go. Show tab 1, show tab 3. Oh, I have it when timeline starts. I wanted to do this when the user actually clicks. So when the user clicks, not when the timeline starts. On rectangle 2, and let's change this one over to when the user clicks. Okay, so now let's go ahead and preview this. So our character is not there. I'm going to click on tab 1. There's our tab 1 content. Tab 2, there's our tab 2 content. And then tab 3, there is our tab 3. Obviously, I'll probably want to adjust the character based on the text there so she's not behind the text. Probably want to remove some of the text so make sure that looks good. But you can see that the concept is there. Now, it doesn't matter which order that I actually go in. So if I come in here and hit replay, let's visit tab 2 first, tab 3, and then tab 1. And the character will still show. Now, just because I want to fix this right now, I'm going to go ahead and go into tab 1. Let's remove these paragraphs here or just kind of wrap it a little bit. I wish that storyline actually wrapped around images. It does not, unfortunately, but we can kind of create our own wrapping as well. So I'm going to copy that text and then paste it into tab 2 and then tab 3. There we go. Just because I'm using the same kind of dummy text here, it works. Now, it may look a little different before the character shows up. So maybe I have the character there, but then just change the pose. But let's go ahead and just click on tab 1, tab 2, and tab 3. And there's my character. Hopefully that's useful for you. Just an easier way to be able to trigger something based on the state changes rather than having to keep track of it when the timeline starts, keep track of a variable on every single tab. This is a whole lot easier to do it based off of state change. And there's even a lot more that you can do with conditions based on state changes as well. We're just kind of scratching the surface here. But if you like this video, head on over to my website and check out all of my other previous blog posts. You can check out everything with learning development related. You can also check out templates and download free templates in Articulate Storyline 360. And you can check out full courses, everything from A to Z with Articulate Storyline 360, Adobe Captivate, XAPI Fundamentals, Camtasia, Articulate Rise, Custom SCORM, and HTML5 video. And if you like this video, also head on over to my YouTube channel, click that like button, subscribe to my channel, and hit that bell notification so you get notified of all future videos as they come out. That allows my channel to grow, allows me to continue to make these videos for you. Also, if you have any other suggestions or anything else that you want to see, go ahead and leave those in the comments below. That's all I have for now, so thanks everyone. I'll see you next time.